Namaskar dear learners, my name is Jainika Senapati and I am from Maniram Devan School of Management, Krishnakanta Hondigoy State Open University. So dear learners, today we will be discussing on a topic from a business environment course which is on labor environment. So let us now discuss about the various aspects of labor environment. By now, you have got some idea on the concepts of business, then business environment, then natural and technological environment. Also, you have gone through the what is called business and business society, and also the industrial policies. This unit has been divided into two parts. In the first part of the video, it will mainly focus on the concepts of labor market, principles of labor legislations, labor legislations and definitions of labor welfare. So after going through this unit, you will be able to learn the concept of labor market, explain principles of labor legislations, classify labor legislations, define labor welfare. So what is labor environment? The labor environment is an important component of business environment. The quality of the workforce helps in achieving the goals of the organization, and the labor forces should be extended the benefits of labor legislation, and they should be given opportunities to take part in the decision-making process. So in this unit, we shall discuss the aspects of the labor legislation, the trade unions, workers' participation in management, and VRS and golden handshakes like concepts in this part of the video and also in the second part of the video. So dear learners, let us now discuss about the concept of labor market. A labor market is a place where workers and employers interact with each other. Employers compete to hire the best and the worker compete for the best satisfying job. Thus, a labor market in an economy functions with demand and supply of labor. In this market, the labor demand is the firm's demand for labor, and supply is the supply of workers as labor. The supply and demand of labor in the market is influenced by changes in the bargaining power of both the parties, that is the employer and the workers or the employees. Suppose in a city, a lot of civil constructions are going on, like construction of the building or construction of the bridges. So a city will attract the laborers, contractors and the workers. If the supply of labor is more, labor cost will be less. And if the number of workers is less, then the required number, the cost of the labor will be high and the industry will suffer from shortage of labor. So this is the supply and demand of labor in the market. Let us now discuss about the labor legislation. Establishment of social justice has been the principle which has guided the origin and development of labor legislation in India. The setting up of International Labor Organization gave a stimulus to the consideration of welfare and working conditions of the workers all over the world, and also led to the growth of labor laws in all the parts of the world, including India. Here in this video, we have to mention about the principles of labor legislation. First, principle of protection. The principle of protection suggests enactment of labor legislation to protect those workers who are not able to protect their interest on their own, and also workers, in particular industries, against the hazards of industrial processes. Then the principle of social justice. The principle of social justice implies establishment of equality in social relationships. It aims at removing discrimination suffered by particular groups of laborers. Then principle of welfare. The main purpose behind the enactment of labor laws on in this principle is to ensure the provision of certain basic amenities to workers at their place of work, and also to improve the living conditions of the workers and their family members. The principle of social security. Social security legislation may be kept under two broad categories, that is social insurance legislation and social assistance legislation. Then the principle of economic development. Improvement of physical working conditions, establishment of industrial peace, provisions of machineries for settlement of industrial disputes, then formation of forums of workers' participation in management, then provision of unfair labor practices, also the restrictions on strikes and lockouts, then provision of social security benefits, and welfare facilities, then certification of collective agreements and regulations of hours of work have a direct or indirect bearing on the peace, and it extend to the economic development. Then the principle of international obligation. This principle postulates enactment of labor laws with a view of, to give effect to the provisions of resolutions adopted by the international organizations like ILO, UN and similar other bodies. Dear learners, let us now discuss about the classification of labor legislation. So on the basis of specific objectives, it is sought to achieve the labor legislation in India can be classified into some categories. Number one is the laws related to industrial relations. The laws related to industrial relations are Trade Union Act 1926, Industrial Employment Standing Order Act 1946, Industrial Dispute Act 1947. Then there are laws related to wages, such as Payment of Wages Act 1936, Minimum Wages Act 1948, Payment of Bonus Act 1965, then Working Journalist Fixation of Rates of Wages Act 1958. There are laws related to working hours, conditions of service and employment, such as Factories Act 1948, Plantation Labor Act 1951, Mines Act 1952, Industrial Employment Standing Orders Act 1946. Then there are some other laws like laws related to equality and empowerment of women, like Maternity Benefit Act 1961, Equal Remuneration Act 1976. There are laws related to the deprived and disadvantaged section of the society, such as Bonded Labor System Abolition Act 1976, Child Labor Provision and Regulation Act 1986, and there are also laws related to social security, like Workmen's Compensation Act 1923, Employees State Insurance Act 1948, then Employees Provident Fund and Miscellaneous Provisions Act 1952, Payment of Gratuity Act 1972, then Employees Liability Act 1938. Now let us discuss about the concept of labor welfare. The meaning and implication of labor welfare differ widely with times, regions, with countries, then industries, also the social values and customs, the general economic development of the people and the political ideologies that prevail in that particular moment of that place. However, there are some definitions given by different scholars. So let us discuss about the definitions. So according to Labour Investigation Committee, labor welfare is anything done for the intellectual, physical, moral, economic benefit betterment of the workers, whether by the employer, by the government, or by the agencies over and above what is laid down by the law or what is normally expected on the part of the contractual benefit for which workers may be bargained. According to N.M. Joshi, welfare work covers all the efforts which employers take for the benefit of their employees over and above the minimum standards of working conditions fixed by the Factories Act and over and above the provisions of the social legislation providing against accident, old age, unemployment and sickness. So, in a very simple way, we can define the labor welfare as the labor welfare implies the setting up of minimum desirable standards of the provision of facilities like health, food, clothing, housing, medical assistance, education, insurance, job security, recreation, etc. Such facilities enable the workers and his family to lead a good working life, family life and also social life. So dear learner, with this we have come to the end of the first part of the video on the unit Labor Environment. Thank you so much for watching this video.